Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Today I'm showing you a microcannula lip filler injection. A lot of people still use needles. Cannulas are becoming more and more common. Several factors. One is safety. I believe they're much more comfortable for a lot of people. People have had needles versus cannula will often request the cannula. And then they're starting to come now included with some of the fillers. So it'll become more and more popular. So let's go to the video and I'll narrate it for you as we see the patient injected. So here's the microcannula lip injections, and I'm using a 26 gauge needle for the opening. Notice I'm spreading the skin side to side, not in and out, not twisting the needle, but actually stretching the dermis. Here, the 27 gauge cannula, I'm putting it in. I hit little resistance to start, but you can see I'll hit a little bit of resistance here. You have two options. You can readjust the cannula, or if you're in a spot where you want a little bit of filler, you want to add some filler that creates a potential space, and then you can move your cannula through it. I'm at the vermilion border here. A lot of people like a little bit of what we call a ski jump for the lip region, and this is where you can create it. This is different from adding volume to the wet dry border. This is actually creating that little curve up of the youthful lip. If there were vertical lip lines, which there are not in this case, I would add some up into the white roll and above this area just to add a bit of volume, because vertical lip lines occur because of a loss of volume, usually as well as a bit of elasticity and hyperdynamic movement as well. Now I'm opening from below as well. I'm showing you the four opening technique. You could come in at the modiolus at the edge of the mouth and just make one opening and do the upper and lower lip from that single opening. But a lot of times I do four openings like this. Now the upper lip has three tubercles, two on either side, one in the center. The lower lip has only two tubercles, and it's easier to fill the lower lip in general, as well as the dynamics of the lower lip, because here you can see I haven't yet had the patient smile or grimace or move. We're simply filling the lip statically, as we say. So we're seeing what we want to fill. We see the areas we want to address, but really we have to address movement too, because everything might look perfect at rest, but then the patient goes home and smiles and it looks very different. That's why the pre-pictures are important, not only statically, but at rest. Now the cannula flexes. There's a couple qualities of this Dermasculpt microcannula, and people use their different versions of it, but the Dermasculpt's the most popular. But it's the flex, the length, and the flow through the cannula. I like the flex, and you can see me a few times flexing the cannula around the lip region, and that allows me to get to different areas. And of course the length, this is a 1.5 inch, so you could theoretically inject the whole lip from one side. I just choose to use four quadrants. Here again, adding a little bit of volume up in the white area of the above the lip area, in the vermilion border, and then addressing the body of the lip or the wet dry. If you're just adding volume and you just want bigger lips, a lot of people don't want that vermilion border filled. You can just add in front of or at the wet dry border. That's going to give you the most volume. You can bolus some areas like I'm doing here in the medial section to give more of a medial lip. And if you fill laterally, you're going to create a wider looking mouth. You can draw a line down from the mid pupil to the edge of the mouth, and that should be a straight right angle perpendicular line. That gives you the idea of the golden ratio of the lip or the perfect width. But of course, the wide mouth is in, so a lot of people like a wider look. Now at the lower lip, again, we made another opening and I'm creating volume here. And you can see some areas of resistance. And a lot of people ask, well, why isn't it painful when you hit resistance? Remember, the mucosal surface on the exterior at the dermal border is where you're really getting a lot of the pain fibers. Underneath, it's less pain involved because the nerves are more superficial typically. We didn't talk much about the anatomy, but the facial artery and then the forms the superior and inferior labial arteries, and that's what we're trying to avoid, of course. And that's why the microcannula, a lot of people believe you get less intra-arterial occlusions. But of course, we're using more volume now in lips, more structurally sound products with a lot more G prime, if you will. And these can certainly cause compression. Of course, hyaluronic acid fillers also draw water in by nature. So things may look good when the patient leaves, but they can draw a little water, and especially in the first few days. And we have to be mindful of this. But in general, I feel a cannula is a much safer method for a lot of people. And also, it can be more comfortable, as you can see here. There's only four openings. Now, you might add a needle type injection to do the central portion of the lip, including the columns or the central tubercle of the lip. Massage is something interesting because a lot of people go home, they'll feel a bump or a lump, and they'll want to massage it out. I massage to make sure everything feels fairly smooth, but keeping in mind the cannula is going to create some fluid, it's going to create some swelling, and just from having an injection done will create swelling. So it's not necessarily the product that people are feeling. I don't advise massaging the lips in the first few days, but by day 4 to 6, if there's a high spot, they can massage it. Now, I noticed I needed more on the patient's right lower lip, so we went in and added more to this side. Each time you go in to the lip, you risk bruising that opening, so try and go in and get the injections and then finish. So there's microcannula lip fillers. Thanks for joining me today. Join us on this YouTube channel. Engage with us below. Same on Facebook and Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.